has got talent. So I mean that sincerely, and where there's no connection, affiliation, relationship, I just think she's a talented young woman. I'm so happy to see her. Every once in a while, you know who I am. I watch The Voice and American Idol. I know. I was dreaming about myself, but I never got there. I made hair instead. You know? But I honestly think of like Bella up there, and I was watching it the other night. I was thinking of Bella and saying, you know, in a few more years, I know you're going to be there. So thank you again. All right, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. As we begin this evening, I want to thank all of you for coming here tonight. I can't do it on my glasses. My first State of the City address. I also want to express my deep appreciation to Mann Lodges for again opening their doors to the Methuen community. I'm always happy to highlight local businesses. They are an integral part of Methuen. And Mann Lodges, as you heard from Senator Ledore, certainly falls into that category. It's hard to believe that only a little less than 4 months ago, I had the honor of being sworn in as your mayor. I am, and I mean this, I am extremely fortunate to again serve our great city in public office. I love it and I appreciate it. Every day I am inspired by the people of Methuen. I am energized by the men and women who work hard to ensure that our residents are provided with the services they need. These public servants are committed to a better future for our city. And I know this isn't in my book, but I practice MBWA, management by walking around. And as I go through the entire city hall and I talk to the employees, I'm on the third floor level, and I go to the second floor and the first floor, and then I cross over and I talk to the employees there, and I go to the second and the third. I want to tell you, they work hard, they are wonderful. I mean that sincerely. And then I thank you, thank you. And then I go, you know, as a member of the chair of the school committee, and I go to the various schools, and I meet with the superintendent, her management team, the teachers, the school committee, and I realized how hard, honestly, and I very much appreciate their hard work. So thank you very much. There is no question we live in a great city, a city of potential and opportunity. As we look at ways to improve with the world, to make it better for all of our residents, our first step must be to ensure that we are balancing the necessities and priorities of today with our long-term vision and goals. One of my first priorities is to ensure that we have an efficient and effective government for all of the city's citizens. For me, that means both looking at the details and at the bigger picture. To help draw a roadmap for the future of Methuen, we have worked with the Collins Center at UMass Boston to create a true comprehensive capital improvement plan for the city, to identify the capital assets that exist here, and to plan for our future capital needs, for as well as, more importantly, how to pay for them. We've all had great cooperation from all the city departments in providing the necessary input for this plan, and I look forward to presenting it to the City Council for review and consideration this fall. In addition, my administration has been working on a comprehensive review of the city's human resource functions, both on the municipal and school side of the house. That work is nearly complete, and we will seek to implement the recommendations we receive to ensure we are providing our city employees with what they need to do their jobs properly. We have also worked in conjunction with the City Council. I want to thank them. They work so hard, and they ask me so many questions. But I appreciate it, because that's what government is all about. It's talking to each other. It's trying to understand each other. It's trying to find out what I'm doing, what they're doing, and that joint sharing. But I have pointed three. Let me go back. I got a good sidetrack. We have worked in conjunction with the City Council to establish a charter review committee to take a fresh look at our city charter and to make recommendations for the legislature. and ultimately, this is important, the voters of Methuen on how to improve our government governing document. I have appointed three highly qualified committee members to join three members of the City Council and a joint appointee with the City Council to carry out this important work. It is my hope that the committee will focus on improvements to our existing system of government without any expectations of making major changes, which would be more appropriately addressed by an elected charter commission. From my first day in office, I began to look carefully at our current budget to identify areas where we could streamline expenses, increase productivity and efficiency, and maximize how our tax dollars work for us. As we finish out this fiscal year and prepare a budget proposal for fiscal year 2019, we are working hard to find the best, most effective way for our city departments to live within their means and to ensure the best use of taxpayers' dollars. I want to be clear that our city faces some serious challenges on the fiscal front. There are always competing priorities, and there has to be give and take throughout our municipal budget. After taking office, we discovered that the cost of some of the collective bargaining agreements negotiated by the previous administration are significantly higher than had been believed. We have reached out to the unions involved to discuss these agreements, and we are pleased they are willing to meet and discuss some of our concerns. Without reductions in the cost of these contracts, it'll be very difficult to ensure that services continue at the level our residents expect and deserve. Although I would love to be able to fund every budget request in full, that is unfortunately not our reality. As mayor, it is my duty to look at the entire picture and to do the best we can to provide necessary services all within a balanced budget. For example, while I understand that the school committee's request was made with a focus on providing everything possible for our students, as is their role, the reality is we may not be able to fulfill the request without causing a significant budget shortfall in the coming fiscal year. Whatever our budget challenges bring, I am confident in the vision and the efforts made by every department. It is my hope that we can work together to weather these fiscal challenges and to find creative solutions to do the business of government for the people of Methuen. Despite our fiscal challenges, the work of government goes on in a variety of areas. We have focused on a few key initiatives during the first 100 days of my administration. I want to take a few minutes to share with you our progress and the work we are continuing to do for you and our city. First among our efforts is the work that has been done to counteract everything Mother Nature threw at us this winter. Our Department of Public Works has done an outstanding job through these past months with clearing our roads of snow in an exemplary manner after the many, many storms. Their fight with Mother Nature continues as they work to patch the potholes and clear the debris and fallen trees she left in her wake. The DPW also continues to work tirelessly to address the issues on all of our city streets, parks, and public spaces to repair the damage. In addition, our water and sewer departments are working continuously to upgrade the city's infrastructure. In fact, over the next several months, they will be upgrading pumping stations and collection systems for our sewer and installing new water meters at every residence in the city of Methuen. After hearing concerns raised by the neighbors and the park users, significant improvements are being made in all city parks. The DPW is executing a citywide parks initiative to address immediate upgrades and modifications to parks throughout the city and simultaneously creating a long-term maintenance plan for our parks. We are working closely with the Forest Lake Commission to make significant improvements to that important resource for the people of Methuen. You will see that right after the summer. Our goal is to ensure that our city's infrastructure is well-maintained and accessible to all the residents of our city. As we improve infrastructure, we also need to create opportunity. Key among these efforts is the ongoing development of Methuen's downtown area, bringing back our downtown to a place residents and visitors see as a destination is so important to our local economy, our local businesses, and our sense of community. This transformation won't happen overnight, but if we build the foundation, we will see a downtown that can and will come back to life. Along with our 40R designation, which allows for a combination of residential and commercial space close to transit, we also have projects in the works to put in new streetlights, better signage, and consider options for enhanced parking to support the new development in downtown as it happens. I am also committed to making our downtown not just a destination, but an experience that everyone can enjoy. From attractions like the new rail trail, which we broke ground on last week, to further integrating the arts in our community. I want our downtown to be a place that enriches the lives of residents and visitors alike. In addition to the downtown, we are focused on how to improve other areas of the city as well. We are working to create affordable housing, which is a huge issue, especially for seniors. As we balance housing as part of the overall development equation, we are also committed to securing open spaces across the city. The development projects in the works have preserved, I want to say that again, the development projects in the works have preserved over 265 acres of open space, while creating over 400 units of housing for new and current city residents to enjoy. As part of these ongoing efforts, we always hope to look at ways to expand recreation along our city's waterfront near Riverside Park, which is now being renovated with assistance from the Commonwealth. By opening up an area where the community can access the Merrimack River for boating and fishing, we can expand how our community comes together. As a first step in this process, I have appointed a waterfront task force to provide recommendations to me about how to expand such uses along the Merrimack River. I am also looking to enhance community programs and events to bring together our residents. We are moving, for example, the 4th of July fireworks to the Loop so that they are more accessible to all. And we are organizing activities this fall and the holiday season with the goal of having everyone enjoy the chance to participate in and enjoy community events. While we look to improve the quality of life and cultural experiences, I am focused on pursuing opportunities to improve our transportation infrastructure. We recently completed the one and a quarter million Pelham-Danton Drive intersection project. We are nearing the finish line on the $66 million project to remove the rotary to open new opportunities at the 110-113 area for economic growth while enhancing security, and we'll be having a groundbreaking in the next couple of months. We are also currently designing a new gateway to downtown at the Five Corners. Additionally, this year we will be actively paving many streets throughout the city, and I know the council is very concerned about that. We have made significant investment in equipment that allows our DPW to better maintain our infrastructure challenges. Having the right equipment now will save us both frustration and money tomorrow. These improvements and investments we make today will better position us for new development in the future, as well as encourage our existing businesses to both stay here and expand their footprint. The future is closer than you think. Our Economic and Community Development Department is working on many more commercial and residential development opportunities to grow our community as well as our tax base. I will continue to work with our team to seek out new businesses and help support those existing businesses so that they can grow and thrive. I will also leverage my long and strong relationship with our state government. Both our excellent legislative delegation and the Baker-Polito administration. At the end of the day, economic development means more funding and jobs in the city, and a better life for our residents. One of the unique challenges we face as a community is having the right guidelines in place to deal with the changes in state law relative to recreational and medicinal marijuana use. Frankly, there were some false starts in the recent past in seeking a comprehensive approach to siting a medicinal marijuana establishment in Methuen. In an effort to ensure that we get this right, I have created a cannabis policy commission in the Department of Economic Community Development to manage the process for siting such a facility. I am pleased with the progress we have made in just a few months into my administration and looking forward to even more success. However, there was one area where we continue to struggle, and we weren't alone here in Methuen. The struggle is the effort to break free of the stranglehold of opioid addiction that has infected our entire state and nation. Everyone in our community, whether directly or indirectly affected, has seen the impact of opioid abuse and addiction. We can't win this fight alone. Within my first weeks of office, I reached out to the governor and lieutenant governor. I signed on to legislation suing the major pharmaceutical companies who I believe addicted not only Massachusetts, but America. And I reached out to the governor, lieutenant governor, and our legislators to advocate for greater access to appropriate treatment, more resources for our community to fight this war, and I spoke to our congresswoman, and I want to echo what Senator Bedore said about she has been a real leader, and I'm so proud to have had her serve as our congresswoman for the last 10 years. I have also begun to lay the groundwork for a more regional approach to this opioid problem, because this is an epidemic bound by city or state lines. I had initial discussions with several community leaders in the area, including newly elected Mayor Joyce Craig of Manchester and Mayor Marty Walsh of Boston. And I'm continuing to build a coalition of Merrimack Valley area and beyond to come together and find solutions that get people the treatment they need, raise awareness, and increase prevention. As we know, we need to do this, and we need to do as much as we can. Methuen can and will be a leader in this fight. We have so much to be proud of in this wonderful city of Methuen, and although we face challenges at times, I am confident that we will succeed in our focus to continue to make this city even better. Whether you're a senior citizen or a senior in high school, whether you moved here 3 days or 30 years ago, I want you to be as proud as I am of our city. I want you to see the potential we have right here. I want you to enjoy what we have to offer. And most importantly, I want you to be confident in our future and know that your city government is here to address your needs and create more opportunities for everyone. Methuen is a place where history meets progress. We have a rich and celebrated history, and I am committed to continuing our progress. Thank you for being here. God bless you, the City of Methuen, the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, and the United States of America. Thank you.